Hello students and welcome to your English language class. Today we'll be reading the poem, The Ball Poem, which has been written by John Berryman. Now John Berryman in his poem describes the grief of a boy over the loss of his ball. The ball is symbolic in the poem as it is associated with the sweet memories of his childhood. No other ball can compensate the loss. With that loss, he senses his first responsibility in a materialistic world, where those whom we love and our worldly possessions will not be with us forever. In our lifetime, we meet so many people and then we lose them. So, this is all about the losses that we face or encounter during our lifetime. The poet sympathizes with the boy but says that like every man, very soon he would also learn to stand up despite all obstacles from the experience of losing something. Now let us read the poem first. What is the boy now who has lost his ball? What is he to do? I saw it go merrily bouncing down the street and then merrily over. There it is in the water. No use to say, oh, there are other balls. An ultimate shaking grief fixes the boy as he stands rigid, trembling, staring down. All his young days into the harbor where his ball went. I would not intrude on him. A dime, another ball is worthless. Now he senses his first responsibility in a world of possessions. People will take balls. Balls will also be lost always. Little boy. And no one buys a ball back. Money is external. He's learning, well behind his desperate eyes, the epistemology of loss, how to stand up, knowing what every man must one day know, and most know many days how to stand up. Now, this is the poem, and let us just read a few lines first. What is the boy now who has lost his ball? What is he to do? I saw it go merrily bouncing down the street and then merrily over. There it is in the water. Now here you can see the poet is talking about a boy who has lost his ball. He wants to know about him and his reaction because he has lost his ball. Further, he asks to himself that what this boy will do after losing his ball. The poet has seen the ball going away from the boy. He says that the ball was cheerfully jumping up and down in the street. Merrily bouncing means cheerfully. The ball was bouncing up and down. This means that when the ball slipped from boy's hand, it went into the street and later on it fell into the nearby river. Now in this stanza, you can say yes, stanza, the literary devices are anaphora. Use of repeated words in two or more lines like what is the boy, what, and merrily bouncing, merrily over. So there is repetition of words. So the literary device anaphora is used here. Assonance, repeated use of vowel O. Boy, now, who, lost. So the consonant O is repeated again and again. Now imagery, when poet says merrily bouncing, means cheerfully bouncing. The ball is personified and it's being imagined as it is very happy to bounce all around. And repetition, what? The word what is being repeated. No use to say, oh, there are there other balls. Oh, okay. Now, no use to say, oh, there are other balls. An ultimate shaking grief fixes the boy as he stands rigid, trembling, staring down. All his young days into the harbor where his ball went, I would not intrude on him. And a dime, another ball, is worthless. Now he senses first responsibility. Now the poet says that there is no benefit of consoling the boy by saying that he will get another ball because he has other balls too. He says so because the boy is feeling very sad. He is completely surrounded by sorrow. He is sad because all the memories of the childhood days went down the harbor or into the river with the ball. Now here the poet is saying that the boy is very sad as the ball, which has now gone into the river, reminds him of those sweet memories of the times when he owned it. This loss is unbearable for him and he is grief-stricken. The poet says that he can't even tell the boy to take some money from him in order to buy another ball because he already has so many balls. He says so because the new ball will not bring the sense of belonging to the boy. Further, the poet says that the time has come for the boy to learn the responsibility of taking care of his things. Now he wants the little boy to grow up and he wants him to be a little responsible about his things. He starts looking after his things properly. So he doesn't want to console him or give him money to buy another ball. Now literary devices are repetition, use of word ball. Now in a world of possessions, people will take balls. Balls will be lost always, little boy. And no one buys a ball back. Money is external. Now, the boy has to learn that in this materialistic world, many of his belongings will be lost. He personifies the ball as his belongings, be it the worldly thing or the relationships he is in possession of. So he says that he has to learn to live without them no matter what. He says no one can buy back such things for him. The poet said so because according to him money can't buy you everything. If it does buy you some materialistic thing, still it will not be able to buy the sense of belongingness. The boy is learning how to stand up against the sense of lost things. This means that the boy is trying to learn the real truth of life, which states that you have to accept the miseries of life and stand up again. Now this is the truth which everyone has to learn in his lifetime. The harsh truth of standing up against the odd miseries of life that everyone has to bear. Now we all must learn how to deal with the losses in our lives, and we have to be very responsible and we have to be really mature. Now the literary devices here are alliteration, like buy is a ball back, the sound of b or b is being repeated. Repetition, ball word is repeated again, and assonance, use of vowel sound e. He is learning well behind his desperate eyes, so e is being repeated here. Now he is learning well behind his desperate eyes. The epistemology of loss, how to stand up, knowing what every man must one day know, and most know many days how to stand up. So he is learning how to bear the loss of something which is very dear to him, and he is learning how to stand up against all the odds in life. And so he wants the boy to learn all these things and he wants him to be really responsible enough. Okay, so this was the poem, the ball poem, and we must learn to be responsible, to be mature enough, and to be able to handle our losses in life. We sometimes lose our materialistic things and we sometimes lose our loved ones. So we must handle all these losses with bravely and with courage, and we should not break down emotionally, and we should be strong enough to endure all the losses in our lifetime. So I hope you have understood the poem properly. Now here's your homework. You have to write the poem in your fair notebook, and you have to write the summary of the poem, and you have to write the question answers too. And if you are not able to understand any of the word or any of the stanzas, then you can ask me in the group. And thank you for watching this video.